This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now.
What
the voice of the must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, welcome to Openly Hostile Opinions. As usual, I'm Jay, and this lovely sack of shit over here is my my friend Casey.
What's up, you sluts?
So what episode are we on now?
I'd say about, I don't know, million and a half, something like that.
Yeah, that sounds about right. This is Trump's America now. We can make up whatever we want.
Yep, fuck it, whatever.
Fantastic.
Yep. So what's today's beer, Jay? Do you want to go ahead and introduce it?
Sure. Today we have Jolly Scott Scottish Style Ale from Appalachian Brewing Company.
Look at that cheery motherfucker, man. He's ready to drink. He's like, I'm ready to drink this, go home, beat my wife, and that's about it.
Those of us who have a penchant for flannel tend to be rather happy folk.
Yes. So let's go ahead and try this motherfucker.
Give it a shot.
Ding dong.
Very typical Scottish ale.
Yeah.
It's got a lot of malt flavor to it.
It actually has a porter taste to it a little bit, don't you think? Porter?
Taste? Well, yeah. I mean, it's got malt. It's the malt you're tasting. That's what you
It's
you
like
get
a light stout to me, to be honest.
You're not really good at differentiating your dark beers, are you?
No, maybe, I don't know. Maybe I just smoke too many fucking cigarettes and I can't taste it all, but...
that probably has something to do with it.
Yeah. No, I really like it, actually. It tastes like a lighter Guinness to me. I'm not joking. Like, that's what I'm getting from this. I wish I could see the color, but I can't dump that water out to pour it in the glass.
Well, most Scotch ales are kind of reddish in color.
Yeah, because it looks dark to me. I don't know.
Oh, it'll be. It's definitely... You're getting the malt. That's what gives that porter taste.
A lot of malt, yeah. It's 5.9%. That's low to us.
Yeah, any more it is.
Yeah, and I just saw, I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but I saw a beer. I think it was in Australia. Of course, it's Australia, but it was like 64% alcohol or something.
It's not beer at that point.
I know. That's what I was saying. I was like, it's fucking, you know.
It's brandy.
Yeah, Jesus's tears or something like that. No, I really like this. I think it's very different. I haven't had a beer like this in a while. I know I probably have because I've worked at a brewery. I've had stuff like this, but this, I don't know. It's really good, though. If I would rate it, I'd give it 4 out of 5 turned down for what's.
I concur. I'll go
that. That fucking song has been stuck in my fucking head forever.
Did you ever see the Hank Hill remix?
Oh, yeah. Turned down for what?
Turned down for what?
Yeah.
Oh!
Like, I only got about, I'm saying, 45 minutes of sleep last night. I'm not even joking. I was playing WoW all night.
last night, nothing. It was this morning.
Yeah. So, like, I was so tired, and then I was listening to music, and that song came on, and it just woke me right up. So, I'm in, like, just a... little weird mood today.
Well, I kind of had to come over early today. Today I have to go for my I guess I have to buy the beer next week.
You have to buy the beer next week. Jay forgot to turn off his phone.
Yep.
For you that don't know, if you forget to turn your phone, you have to buy the beer next week.
Yep, I violated the rule.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, so today is my consultation for the vasectomy. I know I mentioned that before.
I'm so scared for you.
I get to go in today, and I don't know if they're going to be prodding around my nutsack at all, but I need to make sure I'm good and showered up, and I don't want to subject the doctor to salt and vinegar chip dick.
So. You're going to walk in, and you're going to be naked, and they'll be like, what are you doing? And be like, I'm ready. And be like, I'm your dentist, Jay.
Damn, wrong appointment.
Oh, man. I'm scared for you. Are you scared at all?
No, but I'd imagine after this consultation, they're probably going to tell me all the bad things that could happen, and I'm probably going to be scared.
Yeah, but just think of all the raw, unprotected sex you're going to have.
Well, I used to have plenty of that before, but the birth control that the wife was taking, starting to mess with her. It's not good for her.
Yeah, it's not. And I heard, like, there were stories about, like, it's me and my friend Hammer. Well, Hammer was on the show, and they were talking about there's so much birth control in women's urine these days, they can't filter it out of the water. So basically birth control's in all the water.
Well, not enough because I have two kids.
Yeah, I know. Well, it doesn't only work. They say in health class that abstinence is only 100%.
People, I'm sorry. Oh, no matter what your beliefs are, people ain't going to stop fucking.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the thing, Jay. Like, just think, I know this is going to suck. This is fucking weird. I would never do this in my life. But just think of all the raw, like, no surface in your house is going to be clean.
Who says it is now?
Like, it's going to be like even the dishwasher door is going to be fucking, you know, Jay's butt cheeks on.
Enjoy that visual, folks.
Yeah, enjoy that visual. So what do you got for us today, Jay? Anything special?
Well, I wanted to talk about one thing, man, that with this whole election, I know we don't like politics that much, but one thing that I'm going to miss about the last 8 years is we can't say thanks Obama anymore.
I know. I don't know what to do with my life.
We need to come up with a new slogan.
Yeah, we do. And that's the thing. Like, not a lot of things rhyme with Trump. And that's what I'm always going for. Like, thanks Obama didn't really rhyme, but, like, I don't know. I'm thinking of rhyme like
bump the Trump.
Yeah, bump the Trump. That came to mind or something like that. Or, you know, I was trying to come up with something with, like, wig, but I couldn't think of something. And I remember that, like, old meme where he's like, if I lose, it'll be hell to pay. Hell to pay. But that's too long. Like, yeah. I don't know.
We got to come up. You got any good ones?
No, I just don't. I can't think of it.
Comb over crisis.
Yeah. I don't know.
Orange man cometh.
Yeah, orange man cometh. I don't know.
Oh, no, I got it.
What?
Damn it, Donald.
That's perfect.
Damn it, Donald.
That's perfect. Damn it, Donald. Everyone just use that.
Damn it, Donald.
Like, say it's perfect. You're cooking ramen noodles and you fuck up the recipe somehow. Just say, damn it, Donald. Teach your kids. No, don't, because then you'll kill me.
All right, guys, we got a new slogan. Yeah. We can all rally behind. Damn yes. it, Donald.
Everyone say, just damn it, Donald. We'll just make T-shirts, spray paint your lockers at your school. No, don't do that. You'll get suspended.
What would we have said if it was Hillary?
I don't know.
The only thing, it doesn't rhyme. It's not good, but the only thing I can think of is fucking Hillary.
if it was Hillary and something like pissed me off, instead of saying, you know, damn it, Hillary, or anything like that, I'd be like, can we drone that? Like, I'm trying to fix something in my house, and I'm like, son of a bitch, I'm going to drone you. That's a huge
bitch. It doesn't fit, but I like that sound.
I love that fucking sound clip. We got to get more. I have so many more ideas. Like, there's so many good movies out there.
We got to get you your own soundboard.
Yeah, I know. I just...
We're running out of inputs on our mixer, though. I know. That's the problem.
I got to save some money. It's been for some fucking reason, my mom's humped, you know.
Wait, what?
This story's going somewhere. Just give me a second. For some reason, my mom has humped in around the same months because around this time is, like, I'm very low on money this time. Christmas came. My brother's birthday's in November. Mine's in December. My sister's is in January, and my mom's is in February. So I am very low on money. Like, I just spent, I think it was like $60 for my sister's birthday because I like buying presents and stuff. It's really expensive around this time.
You know what my present to everybody is?
What?
I'm gonna go ahead and keep paying my bills so that I don't have to come move in with you.
I know. I can't.
that's been everybody's present for the last few years since I had kids, pretty much.
It's amazing. I would, yeah. And that's what I should say. But you know what the problem is? Your nice. Mom doesn't want you to live with her. My mom wouldn't mind. Like, I'm the last to go, and empty nest syndrome is fucking crazy. Like, if you're the last kid, I feel bad for you. Like, I
but
feel
you're
so
30,
bad.
And it's not like you but haven't lived out
it
on
doesn't,
your own.
It doesn't matter, though. Like, just moms, man. And I don't know. Like, just moms feel useless when the last one goes. Like, they give up their whole life for kids and shit, and then once they're gone, they're like, what the fuck do I... It's like, what's his name from Talladega Nights? He's like, what do I do with my hands?
That'll be Amanda. She's gonna have that real bad when the kids get out.
Yeah, like
I, however, I'm gonna be throwing a fucking party
with the little. I have party poppers you can use.
Hey, there we go. It's like, sorry, kids, you can't come back. I turned your bedrooms into a pool room.
Yeah, fuck yeah, I would. I just seen something on Facebook. They're using shipment containers as pools now. If America couldn't get any more redneck.
I was thinking pool like the game, but that actually could be fun.
I thought you were saying you wanted to put a pool in your... God, I'm so tired. Like, why didn't I put that together?
I have no idea. I don't know.
Okay. All right. All right. I'm awake. This beer is probably
snap out of it.
This beer is probably not helping. It's only 5.9 though, so hopefully I can do stuff later.
So what's going on in the world today?
Let's see here. What do we got here first? So we're gonna talk about a man with a 19-inch penis.
Oh my god, I heard about this.
Yeah, I can't show some of these pictures because I don't know if we'll get fucking banned or whatever. But let's go to this right here.
Definitely, if you guys are watching or listening to the audio podcast on like Stitcher or Google Play, you may want to take a look at our YouTube channel here.
Yeah,
because
we're going to show a couple pictures there, but you can Google this. It's all over glorious. The place. Man 54 rejects the chance to have his 18.9-inch penis reduced, even though he can't have sex until he does. I don't know his name because I'm American and I don't like other civilizations. Robert Esquivel
Cabrera. Roberto Esquivel Cabrera.
Oh, my God. Is that his name or this penis's name? Jesus.
His penis probably does
his name's as long as his penis. So here he is, and there it is. I bet you he always smiles.
Well, all of his pictures he seems to be.
Yeah, like he just, how could you be depressed with that thing? Look at that thing.
I wouldn't want it.
I know, dude. I don't know. Like, I could club people over the head with it.
Like, when he rides in a car, do you think he has to have it ride shotgun?
I know. He probably has a separate seatbelt for it. Like, if I was that thing, I'd use it to roll down the window. Yeah, there he is measuring it. I think, which picture is
it's
it?
It's got, like, some freaking
socks. Yeah, this picture I can't show. This picture I can't show because it gets a little. But he's smiling again. Big surprise.
It's not unwrapped in that picture, but it shows pubes. And
I don't YouTube. Think we can show pubes. Yeah, but there he is measuring. It's 19. And
well, we can, but we don't want our shit to be flagged as 21 and over.
Some of the things here that he just talks about is, and it came popular in 2015. It's 9 inches flaccid. Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. It'd be like a beanbag.
Does that article show the CT scan?
Oh, I can't scroll down. Oh, well,
you're off the...
Yeah, now I can. No, there's a video of it. There he is. Hold on. I got to show his pose. I can't... Hold on. How do we type this up? Yeah, look at that. He's like...
He's proud of it.
Yeah, he is. Okay, scrolling down. I don't know. Yeah. Oh, there's more pictures. Jesus Christ. Holy crap, he's sitting on a stool. It's almost as long as the stool. Oh my God. I wonder if he feeds it.
What would you feed it, small critters?
I don't know, rodents? Dog food? Oh, man. Oh, shit. Oh, okay. I keep thinking that we're on here.
He kind of looks like Terry.
He does a Mexican Terry. if any of you remember Terry. Oh, man. Yeah, so, okay.
Terry the Stoner.
Yeah, because they show an x-ray of it, and it's, like, deformed as fuck.
Yeah. See, here's the funny part about it, though. The dude did it to himself. He started hanging weights off of it when he was in his teens.
Yeah.
And now he's disabled and can't work, so he's collecting Mexican government assistance, which I assume amounts to 2 tortilla shells and a couple of black beans.
And yeah, because he was saying he can't have sex. He's tried twice, I guess, and both times it didn't work out. Because of course it didn't.
The first one ran off, and the second one it just hurt too bad.
Yeah, how do you even I don't know.
Could you imagine a woman no?
Yeah, and how does the fucking sperm make it up the tube that hard? Jesus, could it even make it that far?
I don't know, man.
You'd need a fucking good pump system to get that thing
out. Dude's prostate's probably like a well pump. Yeah,
no. But it's so he did it to himself, and the CT scan was just fucked up. It was all mangled and everything like that. And he wraps a sock around it all the time. But
yeah, to prevent chafing.
Yeah, and he says that he's very depressed. And he not having sex and everything like that, but he won't get rid of it because he says it makes him feel like less of a man.
Yeah, they offered, this is what's disgusting about it, they offered to fix it for him so that he could work and be a productive member of society, and he refuses. He wants to try to start a career in porn in the United States.
Oh, my God.
Because, you know, anybody would want to see him naked except for the morbid curiosity of seeing Count Dicula there.
Count Dicula? High five on that one. That was good.
Thank you, thank you. I'll be here all week.
Count Dicula. Oh, that was funny. Yeah, but
oh
yeah.
No! It's Godzilla!
Godzilla!
Run, Godzilla!
Oh, man. Yeah, so I don't know. Like, he might be able to, because I know a bunch of fucking American women are fucked up. Yeah, I said it. Fuck you all. some fucking porn star is going to be like, oh, yeah, I can take that. And they're probably going to line up to take it. And it's going to hurt the hell out
it's
of
like
them.
Linda Lovelace when she tried to deep throat John Holmes and about died.
John Holmes wasn't 19 inches, though, I don't think, was he?
No, I don't know what it was, because I don't, you know, keep track of porn star penis sizes in my mind.
Why not?
I have a life.
Oh, okay. I don't.
I know you don't.
I don't know why this reminds me, but I was talking with some people last night, and we were talking about when you were born, you had your mom's vagina juice in your mouth. No.
It was poop.
Oh, it was poop. You said that so sad. You're like, it was poop.
No, allow me to explain some things, okay? For all you folks out there who are possibly looking to become fathers, let me give you a little public service announcement here. There's things that they don't tell you. And if you're not prepared for them, like I wasn't, you should probably know a couple of things. First off, during delivery, your wife is going to shit herself. It is not question. It is not a possibility. It is going to happen. It happens to every woman.
Oh my God. Jesus Christ. So I had my mom shit in my mouth?
Well, not necessarily.
Oh my God.
Not necessarily.
It depends on what she ate that day.
Yeah. I must have been breech or something. Anyway, another thing you should probably learn is your kid's going to come out of the womb fucking purple. It's going to look like a slimy purple alien. No one told me this. Like, they come out completely purple. You think they're dead. It's not until they get some oxygen in them that they start turning pink and jiggly.
So you thought your baby was dead, basically.
I didn't know what the hell was going on. I just saw it and it's like...
You're like, it's after me. Then that guy with the 9-inch penis comes in. He's like, I'm scared of you. It starts beating it.
Yeah, see, with my first kid, it was an emergency C-section, too. So, like I told you that story a few weeks ago with Terry the Stoner. You know, they told me not to look over there, and I looked over there, so I already had that fresh in my mind. Then they take me over to my kid, you know, you want to hold her? And I'm like, I don't know if I do. What's wrong with her?
So it's like one of those slime ball things you get out of the 25-cent machine. It's just a bigger version.
And it's just, it's messy, it's nasty.
God, I didn't know they all shit themselves.
Oh, yeah.
It doesn't surprise me, actually, but it just, I didn't know all of them did it. But it makes sense. You're basically taking the biggest dump of your life.
Yeah.
And, like they say, you're basically squeezing a watermelon out of a lemon hole, like a hole the size of a lemon.
Speaking of watermelons, I got a story for you guys later. But anyway, a buddy of mine who had a son also mentioned to me another thing that you expectant fathers should know. Apparently, your boy's going to come out with giant balls. No dick to be seen. Little nugget pecker, but you're going to have, like, giant balls.
Actually, when my sister had kids, I always wondered why newborns have huge fucking nutsacks.
I don't know why that is.
Like, I used to change them, and I was like, why is his nutsack so big?
Apparently, you got to grow into them.
Yeah, like, I was like, holy fuck, like, no wonder kids can't walk when they first come out. And I remember... Oh my God! I had to change my one nephew one time, and the pressure of the diapers was so tight that when he shit, it exploded the back of the diaper out, and it went all up his back.
Oh, that happens all the time.
Yeah, and I was just, oh my God! It was like I put on a World War II German helmet, and like I prepared myself for war because that was horrible. And it was like I remember it being like yellowish orange.
Yeah, that happened.
Oh man,
and carrots.
Like, I've wanted kids for a while now, but now I think I know I don't. Like...
The fact that you can't attract a woman?
I can, just not the right ones.
Well, not the ones that you want to possibly procreate with.
Yeah, like, I was talking to some people about some of my experiences with women, and since they happen to me, I think they're somewhat normal. And to hear other people, you know, be like, what the fuck? Are you fucking serious? I realize that they're not normal.
No. I believe a couple weeks ago we covered some of your bases.
Yeah, like, I don't know. I'm so used to hearing them and all my friends, like, oh, Jay, making fun of me every time about it. I'm used to it. So, you know, when I hear other people, you know, when I tell them the other stories, they're like, what the fuck's wrong with you? And I'm like, I don't know. I was tested. I have no idea. But I got your back. Like my shirt? Oh, you can't really see it. Oh, wait. Wait. Oh, this camera thing. Ah, fuck it.
It's a picture of two stick figures. One has the other one's literal back.
Yeah, there you go. See that?
Yeah,
there you go. I got your back. I got your back, dog. Okay, moving right along.
You sound like you could use a stress reliever. How about that segue right there, huh? Russians apparently have come up with a great way to relieve stress. They call them rage rooms, which also could be a euphemism for masturbation. But
yeah, I get pretty mad when I masturbate. I'm like, you motherfucker.
Beat that some bitch like it owes you money, then cry.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, I didn't want to pay the bills today.
Then get sad because you made God cry. But yeah, so apparently in Russia, they come up with these things called rage rooms. Where you go in there and you just smash the shit out of stuff, like break a bunch of like old TVs and spray paint on the walls. That's fucking awesome. And
I actually thought about this, like I'd say like 5 years ago, because I know Japan was doing this for a while. Oh, and yeah? I'm like, that's fucking genius. Especially around Pennsylvania, because everyone's angry in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, we're not creating stereotypes here.
Yeah, like we're known for our Amish will even fight you. But I know this was popular in Japan, and I was actually reading stuff about how it's making suicide rates go down in Japan because it's getting everyone's rage out. They have a bad day at work. Instead of fucking going home and, you know, making love to a bullet, they fucking go to these rage rooms. They give you any weapon. Like, you walk in, there's axes, there's chainsaws, there's all sorts of shit. There's TVs in their couches, and you just go to town for like 5 minutes and you get all your anger and stress out. I think we should do the purge, but you know, that's a little touchy
something. No. The purge would simply be another way for rich people to take out poor people, just like it is in the movies.
I know, but it'd still be fun to kill people. yeah, I'm not
you
crazy.
Probably should clarify that. You don't have Madonna's clout to be saying shit.
Oh yeah,
like that.
Sorry. Sorry, but no, she didn't really say that. So, you know, let's go there.
I don't even care about that. I'm just saying you don't have the lawyers and the clout to get out of anything if they come tie your ass up and put you in a straitjacket. So I suggest you watch what you say.
I know, a little touchy.
More than the 60 people who watch this show on a weekly basis, Ventures outside of here, you could be in some trouble.
Yeah, I completely forgot about that, which is weird because I've been hearing about it all day yesterday, and I completely forgot she said that. Some guy was making fun of her some because she was, like, talking.
She contemplated blowing up the White House.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I've contemplated dyeing my hair purple, too, so I don't see why anybody really cares. But what do I know?
I know. Just funny shit, man. You can't. Yeah, you can't say that in front of a group of people.
No.
Like, you just can't.
She was just in a moment.
I know, that's the thing.
She's pissed off. There's a lot of people pissed off.
I know, and that's the thing. You got to go to a rage room. But when I think of rage room, I think of a boner room. Like, you just go to get a boner.
Really?
Like, no one likes looking at it in public. Oh, I got to go to a room to do it. So, is there any details on this? Is it expensive?
It doesn't say. It is a paid thing. They did have a psychologist, though. Oh, excuse me. Sorry about that. Like I said before, it's not that I'm tired. I think it's just because I talk and I have like a lack of oxygen going to my brain or something. But anyway, this psychologist said that the concept was fun rather than therapeutic. I'd be against attaching any psychological benefit to it. It's more entertainment. The concept of the room totally equates aggression with destruction. But actually, that's not true. It's important that it doesn't become the only way to channel aggression. So she's saying it's basically entertainment value. It's like you go, you pay your money, you go get some kicks in there, but it's not therapy.
Oh, it would be for me. Man. And I'm surprised that, first, Russia has therapists, and second, that she actually gave them advice instead of, say, drink vodka. Because I thought that's
vodka.
I pictured psychiatrists over in Russia that when you go over there, they just say a vodka. Like, that's all it is. $200. Okay, see you next week.
be one of them big, giant, burly Siberian women, too.
Yeah.
Vodka.
Yeah. That don't wear any clothes. They just warm themselves by their armpit hair.
I might be talking completely out of my ass here, but I think I remember hearing a while back that Siberian men often keep the wife and the girlfriend. The wife is a husky woman to keep you warm in the winter, and the girlfriend is a small woman to keep you cool in the summer.
That's awesome. That's like a
I don't know if that's true or not, but
oh, what movie is that with Robert De Niro and Billy Crystal, where Billy Crystal's his therapist? Analyze that.
Yeah, analyze that. That's right.
Yeah, where he's like talking to Robert De Niro. He's like, "Why are you cheating on his wife?" Or because he's getting a hook or whatever like that. He's like, "She does stuff with her mouth. I can't have my wife do that. She kisses my kids." I'm like, that's a good point.
Oh, I don't care. Like, gargle with that shit and then go go get some scope and you'll be fine.
Yeah, I know. Gotta go scope it out. Yeah.
Scope it. God, that was lame.
I know. I wasn't very punny. I can't help it. I play WoW with a lot of people that love puns, and it gets a little out of control sometimes.
I would say so.
Oh, man. Yeah, but I think that's a great idea. I think we should have that in America. Because I know we're not going to be able to do the purge, so, yeah.
I don't know the way things are going. If everybody keeps separating as much as they are right now.
Yeah, I know. That's why, like, and
shit's getting heated, man.
I know. And another thing, Yahoo, I use you for your mail, not your political views. Shut the fuck up. Like, I have Yahoo Mail, and constantly I get texts.
Why?
I don't know.
But why do you have Yahoo Mail?
Because I needed it. I needed another email quick. When I went to college, I needed an email, and I just thought of Yahoo quick because my other one got hacked by Chinese gold farmers for WoW. And they needed,
I'm starting to notice a pattern here.
What's that?
Your entire life revolves around WoW.
Of course it does.
just
like,
pointing
who
it
else
out
do you know that your college, you know, is having problems signing you up because your email got hacked by Chinese farmers because your WoW account.
For those of you who aren't gamers, gold farmers are people who steal high-level accounts, steal all their items in gold, and sell it.
Yes.
To
yes.
other people. It's not actually like a little Chinese guy plowing fields.
But it's actually, there's so much Chinese farming going on, it's actually boosting China's economy right now. Like,
it's probably state sponsored.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. They actually, a lot of them got in trouble because what they were doing is they were building these huge warehouses, and all these kids were sitting, you know, farming gold. They would sit there and shit themselves and piss. What am I from the south? They would piss themselves, and then they were behind them, they would have ladders, and they would climb these ladders and sleep in these little holes for a couple hours and then come back down. But a lot of them got in trouble. But it was getting so popular a while ago, it was actually boosting their economy over there because it's fucking insane.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Yeah, but I forget what I was talking about. See, that's the thing. That's why I have such a hard time keeping track. Cause
talking about Yahoo's political
views. Oh, yeah.
News.
Fuck you, Yahoo. I don't. And it's just everything. Like, for some reason, they're sending me basketball scores. I don't watch basketball.
Stop. There's an easy solution to this. Stop using Yahoo.
I know, but that's the thing. I use it, and I just, like, it keeps sending me messages. Like, I have something right now. Fox NFL sideline report. I don't care. I don't care. Aaron Andrews has cancer. Who? I don't even know who that is.
Yeah, you have never cared about cancer. Sports, really. Sports in general, really, they're not your thing. You watch some football, but that's about it.
Yeah, I like football. That's hockey, actually. But hockey gets me so excited, I have to, like, choose when I watch it.
I used to watch the shit out of hockey back in the day, but when they went on strike back in the 90s, because I'm old, and I still remember that, I pretty much, like, I lost interest in it, and I started watching football, and I just kind of never stopped.
Yeah. Speaking of 90s, I was talking to a younger person last night, and I was mentioning Lorena Bobbitt, and they didn't know what I was talking about. And it's just like, ugh. It's not their fault, but it just makes me feel so old.
You are old.
I know, and I don't like it. I don't like it.
Did you forget to turn your heat down? It's like 90 in here.
No, I turned it down to 60, actually.
It ain't 60.
You're like, oh, unbuttoning your pants like it's Thanksgiving dinner.
Just unbuttoning my overshirt here. Settle down.
Your overshirt. Yeah, because you got that little appointment earlier, so you don't want your balls stanking.
Well, I didn't shower yet. I'm going home to do that, so I'm fresh as a daisy.
You're fresh as a daisy.
I knew it would be hot in here. It's always hot in here.
Yeah, ever since I got the cold stove or whatever like that, I can't control the heat as much. It's better heat, because with the oil heat, it's only like really warm by the vents, but with a coal stove, it's like a very even heat, so it's like you can't really control it in rooms, which sort of sucks. But I'm fucking poor, and there's free coal downstairs because it was there when I moved in, so I can't be picky. moving right along.
So what's next on the agenda?
Let's go to your little thing here. Do you want to explain this? You were talking about watermelons.
Yes. This is great. This is stoner logic at its best. So the police found 3,000 pounds of marijuana disguised badly as watermelons. Look at these. Look at these things.
That's horrible.
Who's going to buy it?
Can I? What happens if I click on this picture? Okay.
Yeah it blows weird. It up.
Don't say that. Don't say blow up. They might be watching.
Especially after your earlier comment. Look at it. Though. They even took the time to spray a little red ip in there.
I know, but what is the red for? Like the outside of watermelons aren't red.
It's not even like, it's not convincing. They just look like green paper mache.
Yeah, I went to art school. You have the definitely wrong tone of green there. Like, that's just...
Oh, listen to him. I went to art school.
Biggest fucking mistake of my life.
Oh, I doubt that.
Yeah, her name was... No, I'm joking. But anyways, yeah, that's the worst fucking disguise I've ever seen in my life. Like, the only thing he's missing is those little glasses with the nose and mustache. What happened?
Coffee is terrible.
Why?
I don't know.
It's the same as...
It tastes scorched for some reason.
Scorched?
Yeah. Did you leave it on the burner a long time or something?
No.
All right, we'll move.
I was like, did someone put cyanide in your coffee? I thought you were dying over there.
No, it just doesn't taste right.
Scorched.
Yeah, it tastes burnt.
I just realized I play WoW too much. Scorch is the name of a mage spell. God, I'm such a fucking loser.
If you're looking for an argument, you're not going to find one here.
Oh, man, I am such a fucking loser.
Apparently, you need a watermelon, a pot.
Yeah, I know. So what's it say here? $600,000. Smugglers continue to be creative as they attempt to introduce illegal narcotics into our country. I got a burp. Oh, my God, it won't come out.
This is not... I mean, like, they put some effort into it enough to make them green, but, dude...
Yeah, like,
I don't... who would open it up and be like, hey, yeah, look at these watermelons.
Like, those are some fine-looking watermelons. I'm going to love the shit out of those.
Remember, by the way, I don't know if you saw on the screenshots Casey was showing, but the caption calls it the stash.
The stash.
It's the stash.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's... I remember, don't get high on your own supply.
Yeah, I know. Don't drink the bong water.
Like, if you're smoking the pot, don't come up with a way to bring the pot illegally into the
country. I don't even know how people smoke pot anymore. Like, I used to smoke it a long time ago when I was very young and stuff like that. And then everyone just started lacing it with shit and stuff. Like, I can never, like, can anyone even find normal pot anymore? Like, I smoked pot one time with a bombing fluid on it. It was horrible.
I don't know.
I smoked so much of it, I was burping smoke, and then I just puked for an hour.
Yeah, I hate to burst all you people's bubble who probably thought we were high as hell doing this show, but neither one of us smoked.
Oh, yeah, we're completely, well, sort of sober.
We're drinking a beer, but...
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
We don't get high.
Yeah, we're not stoners.
I
we're just fucked up.
I've smoked a couple of joints in my life and I get tired and hungry. I do that just
I know, I just
own.
Smile for about 5 minutes and then my cheeks get tired. And then I just but here's oops, I just hit my mic. Here's one thing that I will never do again is listen to dubstep music high. That was horrible.
I wouldn't listen to dubstep music sober.
Oh, I fucking love it. You know why I think I love it? Because it reminds me of the 56K modem. But don't do it. It's horrible. Like, I was laying there, and I was, like freaking out, and I was like, wah, 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 and I'm like, what's going on? The aliens are coming. It was horrible.
I saw a comic years ago that had a bunch of aliens sitting around a table. Did the humans decode our messages yet? No, but they're listening to it and dancing.
Yeah, that's... Oh, man, that's funny as shit. Yeah, the dubstep's weird. I don't expect everyone to like it, but whatever.
Yeah, it's not my thing. It wakes me up. I'm pretty eclectic, but
yeah, I think dubstep's on its way out though. Like, what's popular now is trap music.
I don't even know what that is.
It's horrible.
Speaking of music, man, the other day I rediscovered something from back in the 90s, man. Fiona Apple, do you remember her?
Oh yeah, what a fucking dirty slut. And I
stop playing, bitch. That's for another story later on down the road.
Oh yeah, I'm like reading the damn, they have big tits for Asians.
They're not Asians.
What the fuck are they?
We'll get into that in a minute.
They look like a painting.
It's bad plastic surgery. Anyway, so yeah, I was listening to Fiona Apple the other day, man. For those of you who are at the proper age, you probably remember her song Criminal.
Yeah, keep going. I'm going to see if I can find a picture of her.
Let's see if you can find a screenshot from the Criminal video.
Okay.
So anyway, she's like this little... She almost had sort of a cabaret singer kind of thing going on for her back in the day.
She's very talented. She was just...
Oh, yeah, there you go.
She just went fucking, like... She was just full, like, being younger, we didn't really know. Like, we were talking about this the other day, and we didn't really know how damaged she was. But now that we older and we were listening to her, we're like, what the fuck happened to her?
She was 17 when she wrote the songs on this, but to be fair, I was little then. So
yeah.
Well, I wasn't that little. I'm a few years younger than her. But
get this on there. Like, this is a part of the video. Like, She was very skinny, very skinny. But then we were looking into it and found out she was like a heroin addict.
No, she wasn't a heroin addict.
Oh, she was anorexic.
She had an eating disorder because she was raped when she was 12.
Yeah, when she was 12. And she's 17 in this video.
No, she's 18 there, but she wrote the song at 17.
There's another one screen. It's basically just her in this house with just passed out people doing drugs and stuff like that.
Yeah, they're in a crack house, but I had no idea what it was at the time.
And she's just singing about how she's a horrible... whorish person.
She's been a bad girl.
Yeah, like that's one of the lyrics and stuff like that, and it's just constant.
But I was listening to some of her other music because you know, as I've gotten older, I've become more eclectic in my tastes, and you know, she's just really, her music's fantastic. It's kind of like this slow, sultry, jazzy piano.
Yeah, like I was telling you, like it's one of those things where your wife cheats on you and you go into, you know, one of those clubs where the table's like this big, so you only can order a drink. And she's like, what can I get you, darling?
A cabaret.
Yeah. What can I get you, darling? A pack's a lucky strikes, and you going home with me, doll.
I'm telling you, if you can appreciate music like, you know, like Adele or Amy Winehouse or those, go back and listen to Fiona Apple.
Yeah, she's
Apple
very
shit.
Talented.
It's very sultry. Like, I've never wanted to fuck a piano before.
Yeah, exactly. And
I'm pretty sure she's like that all the time, like in those videos. Like, if you go over to her house, she probably smells like stale cigarettes.
Yeah, like an ashtray.
And beer.
Yeah, and I love
touch
it.
Touch her, she'll be sticky.
Yeah, but I love it, man. Oh, I love it. Eat your pussy. I fucking love it.
Probably lives in a crack house.
Yeah, and we were like looking stuff up to her because we were like, okay.
Whatever happened to her?
Yeah, well, whatever happened to her? This bitch is obviously damaged, which gives me the biggest rager. But anyways, so...
You love damaged women.
Oh, I fucking love them. That's why I'm doomed the rest of my life. I love damaged women. That's why my goal... was when I went to California was to meet a porn star because I just wanted to meet someone that could fuck for money. But that's a different story. Okay, so we look her up. So basically she was raped outside of her apartment when she was 12, okay? And this is, you know, where she gets not really any of her – what's that word for? Shit, I can't think
inspiration.
Of it. Inspiration.
Yeah, let me look up the actual quote. Go ahead and say it.
But. So she gets inspiration. She really doesn't, because she basically quoted something. Jay will look it up here in a second. But rape is basically boring. So she didn't want to write about it. But I just don't think rape would be boring. And I'm not saying it's fun, but I think it would give me some inspiration to write my music. She says no.
Okay, so she said in 2000, she insisted she didn't write songs about being raped. She said, and I quote this, it doesn't get into the writing. It's a boring pain. It's just such a fucking old pain that, you know, there's nothing poetic about it.
Oh, my God.
Like, really? She's, like, bored by the fact, I was raped, whatever. Fuck it. It's nothing. It's not,
I know. And the only thing
not interesting.
Yeah, and the only thing I could think of was, like, maybe she's just bored of hearing about it or dealing with it. Because it probably is very psychologically, like, you watch that video for 5 minutes, you're like... Or like 5 seconds, you're like, who in the fuck beat her? Like,
it's just looks like she's all strung out.
Yeah, she's just strung out. And then that's why she's so skinny, because she had an eating disorder. it affected her, which it would.
Yeah, she wanted to make herself look weird so she was never attacked again. You know, a lot of people go through psychological trauma like that.
Yeah, like when I was jerked off in a bar when I was puking, it sort of made me feel weird.
Yeah, it's worse for women, though.
Oh, yeah, it has to be.
You know, I think what it is that this is where shit's about to get weird, so be aware. I think
shit's starting to get weird right now?
Yeah.
We're talking about eating our mother's shit.
I think it's the fact that they get penetrated, because, I mean, that has to be such
Just the whole idea.
Just the whole submission thing of being held down and penetrated, even during a consensual act.
Yeah, like, bitch, you're going in dry.
I just feel like the whole thing of sex. Yeah.
Of being on the other side as a woman is weird to me. Like,
yeah, because we're naturally, just by our plumbing, are the aggressors.
Yeah, and just to lay there and have this fucking plunger go into your toilet for, like, however long, you know.
Way to make the act of making love sound beautiful.
Yeah, it's just fucking weird, man. And that's the thing, just to have another guy that you don't want inside of you. And, like, 12 years old? Like, dude, like, seriously? Like, 12 years old, that's like trying to put a sledgehammer through a keyhole.
that's why it infuriates us so much when we hear people scream rape about stupid shit that's not rape.
Yes.
Because, yeah, exactly. You know what? Just to put yourself in the shoes of somebody who's actually been raped.
Yeah.
Who actually legitimately was assaulted, held down, and fucked against their will.
Yeah.
You know, that's a horrible thing. Because somebody wouldn't hold the door open for you, you have not been raped.
Yeah.
Because a man hit on you.
Said hi.
You have not, you know, you Tumblr fucks haven't thought for a moment about the actual pain these people go through.
Yeah.
That's what irritates us. It's not that we are against people who legitimately have had these kind of traumas happen to them.
Well, that's the thing, and that's the way people are. Like, the big word is triggered these days. It's like, I've seen people with actually mental disorders that get triggered.
I've seen people with real PTSD.
Yeah, get triggered, and it ain't fucking, you know, cool, but people just use it in, like, OCD. I see that a lot. But it's like, if you know someone with OCD, where they wash their hands so much their skin falls off, you know, it's just people don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Like, she hates me talking about her on the show, so hopefully she doesn't watch this one, but my wife has a little bit of OCD.
Yeah.
Hers is super mild, so don't even think I'm trying to say she's got the same problem as somebody who has to flick a switch 20 times before leaving a room.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, especially when she gets under stress, like, I've seen her, she has to go and make sure, like, the shoelaces aren't touching on every pair of shoes, and they have to be lined up perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, if she checks on one of our kids before she goes to bed, she'll stand there, check them, make sure they're breathing, walk back out, walk back in a few times.
Yeah, she has rituals.
But it only seems to manifest when she's stressed out or overworked.
Yeah.
So, for the most part, her life is easy to live, but I couldn't imagine.
I know. I like
the people who are chained to their rituals.
I had to study that shit in college, and it was fucking insane. Like, we were studying this postal worker, and he had really hardcore OCD, and, like, every package, every envelope that he had to take out of a mailbox, he would take it out, put it back in, look to see if it's, you know, still in there. And he did it over and over and over again, then get in his truck, go to the next mailbox.
They had to have fired him.
Yeah, I know. And that's the thing. Like, I don't really think they know, because he was there forever doing it over and over and over again. And then they'd have to connect the dots and be like, why is he taking so long? Like, and it just, people use words and they just think it's funny. Like, edgy's the new thing or something.
I don't know. We've been guilty of it too, but in all honesty, we do understand what these real people go through.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. We're just fucking cunts, but whatever.
Yeah, we're dickheads, but at least we're not, you know, awful.
Yeah, it's just funny. But and that's the thing. Like, I see people say, oh, I have OCD. It's like, no, you don't.
No. Because you obsess over getting a term paper in on time does not mean you have OCD.
Yeah, it's just...
Somebody who has a debilitating, crippling... thing that they have to do, even knowing it's stupid.
Yeah, like being this ugly.
Well, that's the funny thing about OCD is the people who have it know that what they're doing is ridiculous and nothing bad will happen, but they still can't stop
it. Yeah, they can't stop it. They have to have rituals or they feel like they're going to die.
Or somebody close to them or whatever their brain is telling them is the problem.
Yeah.
You know, it, on the same line, I watch Hoarders sometimes. You ever watch that show?
Oh, my God, it's got awful.
Oh, fucking, yeah. You know, and I find myself getting so frustrated with these people. I was watching one the other day. It was like an hour long special, and it was just focused on this one lady, and she was an interior designer, mm-hmm. and lived in this mansion for 40 plus years and just filled a mansion, an actual mansion of shit. And then she sold it. I didn't see the beginning, so I don't know why she sold it, but anyway, mm-hmm. she sold it to these two gay guys. And these people have to be the nicest, sweetest, most caring,
instead
understanding.
Of filled the mansion, they filled each other. Hey!
Sorry. These two have to be the sweetest, most caring individuals I've ever seen, because they were actually, if you've ever seen the show, you know how people are there to support them and try to help them and talk them through the whole, the sorting process and things. These two guys were doing it just like they were family members with her. And until the therapist basically said, okay, you got to get tough with her now. It's like, you have to give her a deadline, say this needs to be done.
Yeah, because I remember that's what they usually do. Like, they're nice at first, and then they're like, they have to start. Because then they show them, like, start taking out of the dumpsters. They're like, no, they're, like, freaking out.
Well, this lady was beyond help. She refused to listen to anybody. And these two guys, like, when it was all said and done, and they finally had to, like, the city came and threw her out and took her shit and threw it away.
Yeah.
Because it was that they kept taking it out and putting it on the street.
Mm-hmm.
Which you can't do.
Yeah.
The city was nice enough to even give them a permit till 5 p.m. that night to block off that street. And then after that, it had to go. And the city came and threw everything away. These two guys were sitting there bawling their eyes out over her having to lose 40 years worth of things.
Yeah, and that's death to them. Like, that is fucking, you know, like that, life or death. That's what it feels like to them. It feels like they're dying.
But the point I'm trying to make is I get frustrated, you know, watching it. I can't imagine being somebody who has to live with their brain doing that.
I know, and it sucks, because when I first watched it, and I was like, hoarders, is that people addicted to whores? And then it wasn't. And I was let down. I was like, there's someone out there like me? You get me. You really get me. And then I was like, oh, shit. I know. I'm a horrible person. I can't fucking help it. Whatever. So
you want to talk about these two now, don't you?
Yes, I do.
There's going to be a video that pops up. You should probably stop it right away, because it'll be annoying.
Oh, they're so weird looking.
Hit cancel.
Uh-oh.
Cancel.
Right there. Where's it at? Jesus Christ. It's not canceling.
All right, whatever.
Let's see here.
You can stop it.
They're so horrible looking.
Well, they're aware of that. Here, show this.
Oh, they know they look like shit?
Oh, yeah. What the fuck?
Oh, my God. I fucking...
I hate ads.
Oh, my God. This is annoying.
I have a Wired Wednesday coming up, and then probably this week, talking about some ad things. So look for that. It might be out tomorrow.
They look not tomorrow. So bad. They look like paintings.
Yeah. Okay. So check it out. These two are Australians, and they are identical twins, and they've spent a whole fuckload of money. How much was it? Yeah, $150,000 to look exactly like each other, and they got lip fillers and breast implants and eyebrow things. And
yeah, what are those? Like, are those eagle wings? I don't get it.
So anyway, these two Australian chicks, they live in the U.S., but they actually have admitted what we thought was pretty, we find ugly now. They overdid it. They know they overdid it. But here's
really what, you think.
Here's where things get interesting. Yeah. Scroll down a little bit there and show it off. Keep going. There you go. They're getting married to their boyfriend.
Oh, my. What do you mean boyfriend?
Yeah, you heard me. Boyfriend.
Who would marry a painting? Like,
they share everything, including a boyfriend.
Oh, you down dumb motherfucker. You are fucking dumb. You are fucking retarded. Not only do you have to deal with one period, you have to deal with two periods.
Yeah, and
have fucking fun with that.
They haven't gone out and said about the periods, but they said their bodies are exactly the same. They get horny at the same time. So he gets twice
the
love.
Okay, hold the phone. That's pretty cool.
He has to do twice the work. They have sex with him at the same time.
That is beautiful. I love it.
Keep going down. Look at this weirdo.
I hate the way they look, but doggy style, you know. He's so happy. He's so happy. He's like,
I don't know.
Luckiest man on earth.
Go a little further down. Look at the next picture. There's pain in those eyes.
Oh, yeah. He looks a little sad there. He's like, what the fuck did I get myself into?
Yeah. They even said if one of them gets pregnant, the other one must get pregnant immediately afterwards, because their bodies must be the same.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. There's people starving in the world, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, they actually said, we're in the mood at the same time. He's a lucky guy. He needs double the energy. He gets double the love and double the attention. We're not hurting anyone, and it makes us happy.
Yeah. If this... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
I'm just saying, speaking of mental disorders, yeah, these two need to be evaluated.
If this motherfucker is dealing with both of you, and he comes home from work and wants to sit on the couch and have a beer, let him have a fucking beer. Like, this guy...
Yeah, they shower at the same time. They do everything together.
Do they realize how they look together? Because they look fucking horrible.
Yeah, they do. That's the point. They kind of regret all the surgery. They're going to start getting some work done to try to get more back to a more natural appearance, they said.
Just
okay. Yeah, listen to this shit. Anna said, if I got pregnant, Lucy would definitely get pregnant straight away because our bodies need to be the same. We would try to make that happen, definitely. We're not trying right now. We love children. Kids love us, but it's not time for us. Thank God for that.
Jesus
Christ. We would have to be exactly the same, even if we went through IVF at the same time. They actually became famous. They were dubbed the world's most identical twins on a Japanese TV show because the facial recognition technology couldn't tell them apart. In fact, the only difference I see between the two looking at them is the one has a little tiny mole right next to her nose. Like, and it's not even like a colored one. It's just one of them little white bumps.
Huh.
Like, it's right there on the screen. It's the tiniest little thing.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I'd like tie a balloon to one so I know which one's which.
Well, I'm guaranteeing he uses that little mole to tell him apart.
I know. Oh, man.
If one of them
so
look,
fucking ridiculous.
Oh no, wait, that's I was going to say maybe it looks like there's a mole on one of their breasts, but no, that's my black spot on my screen. I didn't clean my screen up.
Like from the scorched coffee.
I don't know what's up with that. Might even be my cup. Maybe it needs rinsed out.
And see, this is, I don't get it, man. Like, I just don't get, they must be rich or something. I just don't, like, I don't have money to spend on stuff like that. It's just so weird to me.
I don't know. Some people make it a priority. I mean, like me, I would love to have more tattoos, but I have a couple, you know, but I just never got around to spending the money on more, but I would love to have a lot more.
I just don't get why people want so much. Like, what are you doing? Like, I was talking to someone last night, and they're in their, you know, early 20s like that, and they're telling me, they're like, I always feel like my life isn't good enough. I'm like, get fucking used to it. I'm like, because it gets worse when you get older. So this is what you do. You get around people that love you, and you just appreciate it.
I mean, maybe it's just me, but I'm content with my life.
I know, and I am too. And I just, like, I don't know why people want so much. Like, just, and like I said,
we get idiots on the internet who watch us on a weekly basis.
Yeah, like me and Jay, like, we wish more people would watch us, but we're still doing this because we're just having fucking fun.
Yeah,
like,
really.
We just don't. We just appreciate that
we're going to make you love us. We're coming back week after week till you do.
Right. But anyways, but like we just appreciate doing this. It's fun. It gives me something to do on Tuesdays. Like, I didn't do a lot on Tuesdays because I have off, and it's just like it gives me something to look forward to. Like, I appreciate this that,
yeah,
you know,
for
some reason, God hasn't killed me yet, and he's letting me, you know, give my voice out a little bit for some fucking reason. I think he feels bad for me because he made me ugly.
Yes, he did. He made us both ugly.
Yeah,
I was lucky enough to find somebody who can look past it.
He's like, I feel bad for you guys. You can have this.
Well, speaking of the internet and what it gives us, let me break in for that. How about that segue right there?
Yeah, that was good.
All right, so for those of you not watching on YouTube, definitely subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're also available on Google Play, iTunes, Stitcher. Definitely check us out if you're looking for a good podcatcher. To listen to the audio, Stitcher's an excellent one to check out. We're on that now. Most podcasting apps we're available for. We have a website going called openlyhostileopinions.com. It's not finished yet, but I'm working on it slowly but surely. Eventually, we'll have that a little more fleshed out and let you know what we got going on. If you want to support what we're doing here, you can go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. For as little as a dollar, you get exclusive content that only our patrons get. Exclusive videos, behind the scenes type things. You can get some various other levels of prizes and things there.
Ding, ding, ding.
We're probably going to be starting a merch section before too long. So if you guys want to buy shirts and shit like that, we can do that. If you have any specific things you want, shoot us an email, openlyhostileopinions@gmail.com. You can find us on Twitter at hostileopinions, facebook.com/openlyhostileopinions. We're on there. Google Plus. You can find us there with a quick search. So any of those social media things, if you like what we're doing, be sure to give us a thumbs up, write a review on iTunes or whichever podcatcher you're using. That helps us a lot. And please, share it with your friends. The more the merrier here.
Share us with your friends, just not your diseases.
That's all right. We have a condom on our Ethernet jack. We're good.
Yeah.
keep them viruses out, dog.
Yeah, motherfuckers. That was pretty good, Jay. That was pretty good. I like that.
Yeah, there we go.
You're getting good at this.
getting good at being a corporate media whore.
Corporate media.
Please, whore. People, please. You don't understand what subscribing means to us. Because once we have 100 subscribers or something like that, we can have a URL that says youtube.com/openlyhostileopinions instead of youtube.com/xy4732. Yeah,
no. 3.5 AIDS. Come alpha on, beta.
Come on, subscribe, man. Subscribe. Okay, no, I'm done now.
Yeah, I know. We reached like 50, I think, or we're like 49 or 50. 48, and then just somewhere. Stopped. Yeah, it was like boop boop doo. Like it was just. Yeah, we're just like, oh, okay. We're like, yeah, we were all excited. We're like, yeah, 49, 49.
Here it goes,
like,
here it goes. Come on. Yeah, it was just we're like, halfway what? There, just about.
It was like the DeLorean did not hit 88 miles an hour. Like. Just fucking, yeah.
I know it's a lot to sit here for an hour for a show, but hey, think of us like your morning show. Yeah. Let me give you guys a tip here. Here's a little Wired Wednesday break-in for you. One of the best ways to enjoy our show is on your back and forth drive to work. If you download a podcatcher like Stitcher or iTunes has their podcasting app. Google Play does it, and there's tons of other ones. Pocket Cast is a good one. You have to pay a couple bucks for that one, but it's a really good one. You can download different podcasts, including ours, to your phone. Mm-hmm. Plug it into the auxiliary jack on your thing and listen to us instead of Bob and Tom or Stern or whatever it is you're into.
Yeah, when you're doing the dishes, listen to us.
Yeah, give us that, or like I said, back and forth to work. That's a good place to do it. And there's tons of other, if you're not into podcasts and just watch us, there's tons of great content out there. There's Two Bearded Guys. It's great. If you're into candy, what's that one?
Sugar Daddies.
The Sugar Daddies. Yeah. That one's good. There's tons of podcasts out there. Tons of entertainment. If you like what's going on here, check them out.
Yeah. And that's the thing. Like, I've never been into podcasts. Surprise World of Warcraft podcast. Like
there's a shocker.
Yeah, that's pretty much what I get to, but this is all basically new to me. I know Jay has more experience with this stuff because he's been like an Open Anthony. I've been a Howard Stern fan for a while, but like I never realized how crazy of a community podcasters have. And the hardest thing is I'm so busy. I want to be a part of it. And I'm trying, like I'm part of a couple Facebook groups and stuff like that. And I'm trying. I'm just so freaking busy. And there's a like every once in a while, like someone will ask a sound question, I'll try to help them or something like that. But it's like
we're still learning ourselves here, obviously.
Yeah, because it's a whole new world that I knew nothing about, and it's awesome. Like I said, this is how I found out that there's a huge falling for true crime.
Yeah, there's a lot of true crime podcasts. There's podcasts for everything. There's people who tell serial stories. Those are neat.
Yeah,
so it's sort of like Audible.
Yeah, and there's fictional. True crime podcasts where these people. Which I think is pretty cool is they make up their own stories.
Yeah, and they tell them in a serialized format. Those are pretty neat.
Yeah, it's a whole new world. A whole new world.
Slapped with a copyright claim.
Yeah, I know. No, it wasn't that good.
Well, yeah, you know, like I've been for years a big fan of like Morning Zoo talk radio programs like Stern and Opie and Anthony and Man Cow in the Morning and Imus. You know, and that's why we do this, because we both grew up listening to shit like that, and, you know, Stern, and we loved what they did. So because of the internet, we can do it now.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is great, but there's tons of other people who do the same thing as us and a lot of different other ones. So check out some of those things and start listening to some of these podcasts. God knows you can always pick a different one if you don't like what you hear.
Yeah, that's like spin the wheel. Not that fucking jelly bean wheel.
I was going to say, you want me to get the jelly beans?
No, that's quite all
right. We still got plenty of them left.
No, that fucking game is horrible. Whoever thought that up, you're fucking Hitler. Like, Hitler is still alive. Fuck you. You know? Jesus fucking Christ, man. Not doing it. Nope.
So, I read something interesting today, and I want to get your take on it. A couple of days ago, the New York Times published something. And it said voting should be mandatory.
No, go fuck yourself.
well, give it a chance here. Apparently, in Australia, voting is apparently mandatory. Mm-hmm. And when you look at some of this thing, a lot of very important decisions are made by minorities. I'm not talking about black people, women, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. I'm talking about just a small segment of people.
Basically on their opinions.
Yeah.
Is what you mean.
Okay. Like, for example, you know, the Brexit thing. When the British folks voted to leave the European Union, only 37% of eligible voters are the ones that decided that. 37%. I mean, that's kind of a scary figure. And I don't know, don't have a percentage amount here for the American voters who went out and voted for Donald Trump. But I know it was something like a third of eligible voters are the only ones who went out and voted.
Yeah,
including Colin Kaepernick didn't fucking vote. You bitch.
I'm oppressed.
Yeah, I'm oppressed. Let me do nothing about it. Anyway. So there's a few countries out there, including Australia, like I said, that you can actually be penalized for not voting. You know, I think it's a good idea because, you know what, at least if every man, woman, and child, well, not child, obviously, but a man and woman who is eligible to vote under our current system went out and did the vote, we really couldn't argue. It really would be majority rule at that point. We know that there's not a silent majority of people out there who just didn't go out on the polls that day. Nobody could bitch.
I know, and here's the thing. Like, I've said this numerous times. Why I think this is a bad idea, one, because I think voting's rigged anyways. Call me conspiracy theorist. I don't give
a fuck. You are a conspiracy theorist.
I know, but I don't give a fuck. Like how you don't like the word social justice warrior. I think conspiracy theorists is just a way to make fun of someone because they know they're right.
I don't like social justice warrior because everybody lobbies it against the wrong people.
I know, and that's the thing. That's one of the main things is when people are against you, they label you. It's the easiest thing to do.
If you have a progressive ideal, God forbid you think women or black people should be treated like people.
Yeah, I know.
You're a social justice warrior all of a sudden.
You have to label people. And it's like, I think it is so dangerous in the type of world we live in these days. Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Because of voting systems, because of how, you know, easy it is to take advantage of them, how easy it is to manipulate them. And the problem is I think it makes us very docile. No one's really trying to fix the problem because they think we have a choice in fixing the problem. And we really don't.
I don't know. There was a 500,000 people who marched on Washington this weekend who are actively trying to fix something.
I know, but it didn't do anything.
So even if, you know what, though?
Like a lot of them didn't get fed that night because the kitchens were empty.
But you got to give them credit, though. Even if you don't agree with what they're marching for, at least people went out and did something.
I know, and that's the thing. Like, I'm the kind of person that this is what vets fight for. This is what people in the Army fight for. It gives you the right to do it, like the Kaepernick thing. If we start losing that, that's the whole point of America. It's fucked up what Kaepernick did. It is. But the whole reason why we go and fight for, you know, America and stuff like that and try to protect it is so people like that have the voice to do it. But I think what the problem is these days is we're becoming too docile because we really don't know what the problem is. We know, like, when you lived in, you know, Germany and during the thing of Hitler, you knew he was the fucking problem. Today,
or you thought the Jews were the problem. Either way, you had
nothing. Either way, hey, quads, whatever. But today, we really don't. We know there is a problem. We have nowhere to do it because there's this illusion that we have a say in it. And I really don't think we do. It's like Coke or Pepsi. Oh, I have a choice which one to drink. You're probably going to get diabetes or cancer. Like, it's just different animals saying shit.
I mean, when you look at the choice between Trump or Hillary, they're both bad options.
Yeah.
Plain and simple. But
like, we've talked about this before, Lewis. Which way do you want to get to fuck? But
yes, but two animals, same shit.
Yeah. And the thing is like, I wish I was like you. Like, I really do.
Because, the optimism part?
Yeah. I did a lot of research back in the day, and this is why I have a problem with politics. It's not that I disagree with people. It's just I'm spoiled. I'm not spoiled, but I'm just damaged with the way. I did a lot of research, and everything makes sense to me. Everything really does make sense to me.
Look for patterns in the wallpaper, too. If you look hard enough, you'll find something.
And it's just like I just wish I had that thing that – because if I didn't think the way I did, I'd be like, oh, great. Yeah, that should
be. But you know what? I believe people have the ability to change things. And I think that actually people aren't empowered enough. I believe in getting rid of the Electoral College. Now, a lot of people disagree with me on that, but I think it's stupid because I believe that my vote should count exactly the same as somebody from Rhode Island or somebody from Arizona, but it doesn't. No. My vote, I live in a district right now, okay? As you can probably guess, as Jason would call me a commie, as you can probably guess, I generally will vote Democratic. Not always, but generally. I live in a district that has voted Republican overwhelmingly for the last 37 years. So my vote literally doesn't count.
I've been saying this for years. It's a fucking, it's
and you know, it's a system designed that unfairly takes the power away from the people.
I know, and it does. That's what I'm saying. It's a fucking scam. It's a scam.
It is.
It's just, it's bullshit.
I mean, like, you know what?
And it's working. And that's the bad thing. And this is why I get so fucking frustrated. Because when this shit was going on, I see fucking all these Facebook posts of all these people with stickers. I voted. Good fucking for you. What'd you change? Absolutely shit. Like, you didn't change fucking nothing. Your voice didn't matter. This last election proved that your fucking voice didn't matter. But you know what you're going to do? You're going to fucking think it's going to next 4 years. And it's fucking not. And here's the thing. You should learn from this shit. You should adapt to it. But you're not going to. And that's the fucking problem I have with it.
Well, but whatever. You know what? If this election is enough of a wake-up call to get more people out to the polls, that's great. But you know what? Like I said, Australia, they make you go. I think it'd be good.
I know, but even if it... I don't know if there's works like ours, but even if it does with the Electoral College, it might not really work.
Theirs doesn't work the same as ours. They don't have the Electoral College. But here's the point they make, and I think that this is the part that really swayed me to understand what they're talking about. Hang on a second. Okay, here we go. In a compulsory election, it does not pay to energize your base to the exclusion of all other voters. Since elections cannot be determined by turnout, they're decided by swing votes and one in the center. Australia has its share of xenophobic politicians, but they tend to dwell in minor parties that do not even pretend they can form a government. Mm-hmm. This is the one reason why Australia's version of the far right lacks anything like the power of its European or American counterparts. Australia's had some bad governments, but it hasn't had any truly extreme ones and isn't nearly as vulnerable to demagogues. Well, the reason that it's saying is, you know, when you have to appeal to every single man, woman, and child in the country, you can't be an extremist, because if you are, you're going to turn them off. And I think that's a good check and balance to make sure that people with extreme viewpoints don't end up in the highest ranking office in the land. And I think that's where it might be a good idea to maybe consider this, although it'll never happen. And you know, this is one of those let's play pretend moments.
Yeah, and just throw away my bias and everything like that. It is a good idea, but it's just like I think the problem is voting. Like, it just is, because it's just it gives people hope, and like the past election should show that it's there's just something wrong right now. It's too, like that one quote where they're saying on, you know, that every politician should wear sponsors like NASCAR drivers so you know where their money
that's a good point.
Yeah, it's just a big problem right now is we don't know what the problem is, because there's so many politicians out there that you think you have a choice to vote for, and it makes it dilutes everything. Everything fuzzy.
The fact of the matter is Donald Trump was definitely out of the establishment. So if you, for those of you people who wanted chaos to reign supreme, you succeeded on that.
Yeah, and I mean, so many people so upset about this last, you know, election, and I've been saying this for years. Your vote doesn't mean shit, and everyone is so upset about it. And it's like, I've been saying this for fucking years, and I'm not the only one. George Carlin was saying this shit in the 60s. Yeah,
and everything boils down to fucking memes and fucking little slogans nowadays. I mean, Donald Trump, for example, won largely on slogans and like name calling. You know, he came up with a couple of fucking funny little phrases like Little Marco and you know, Crooked Hillary, and you come up with these couple of names, and then people just like latch onto it. We're the meme culture.
Yeah, and I just don't fucking care anymore. Like, and that's why I said, like, I don't want anything anymore. Like, I live in a really good place. I have really good friends right now, and I found people that love me, and I'm just gonna fucking stick with it. And I don't know.
I don't think there's anything. Here's where you and I differ, though. I have the optimism that people do have the power to make changes in their world.
I do, too. But I think we're losing that. And I think we're losing it.
Well, it's people's own laziness, myself included. I didn't vote. Why didn't I vote? Because I didn't drive my ass down to the polls because my vote didn't count. I just explained that to you.
And that's the thing. And then that whole, like, oh, you didn't vote. You don't have a right to voice your opinion. Fuck, you don't.
Yeah, I do. Because honestly, my vote would have just gone into the void. That's why I support a popular election.
And exactly. And it's like...
Did you hear about the movement that some states are trying to make now trying to be like a workaround around the Electoral College? Instead of agreeing to have their elector vote for whichever party won their state, they like 15 different states have banded together and say that we are going to cast our votes for whichever candidate won the popular vote.
I'm surprised that
Every single, well, I'll tell you why it's not going to happen, and it's you know, it's more bipartisan bullshit. A popular vote favors the left more than it does the right, because the left is more concentrated in large cities and has there's more left leaning members of the country than there are in the right, but they're concentrated in small areas, big cities, things like that, more diverse populations. Whereas, you know, in your Midwestern states and whatnot, it's all more spread out and there's less people. But, you know, like somebody like Montana, which has a fairly low, or Oregon, I think, has a very low population. Mm-hmm. They have a decent sized number of votes in the Electoral College because it balances out, you know, because basically Oregon's people wouldn't be represented, but they absolutely would, because every human being would be represented at that point. I think it's asinine to assume that splitting things up makes people more equal.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I know that. Just
because you live in New York City doesn't mean your vote should count less than somebody in Oregon. I don't care.
I know, and this is where I have been saying for years and years and years, but I also have been to get rid of the Electoral College, but I also have been saying I get why they did it, because it's easier when there's larger concentration of people, it's easy to corrupt them and change their minds. And it helps spread out, but I still think you should get rid of it. But
with today's day and age, with social media and television, everybody gets the same message.
I know, and that's what I'm saying.
It's not like that anymore.
I know, but like cities about, like, you know, giving free stuff to people and shit like that, that's where it becomes a problem. I'm not really talking about internet and stuff, but it's like, I still think you should get rid of it.
Well, here's the part where
Everyone's vote does matter. I would fucking vote. I don't even believe voting works, but if they got rid of the Electoral College, I would actually vote.
I would too.
And I think it's rigged. Like, I would.
I just don't, you know, I don't understand a lot of the things that go on in the world today, but whatever.
And my vote would go to shit, too, because I wouldn't vote Democrat or Republican.
And that, you know what?
It's another honestly, of choice.
Honestly, if everybody's vote counted, a third party would actually have a fucking shot.
Yeah, probably. Because
they would be on equal footing as everybody else.
And that's another thing. I'm just so sick of this Democratic-Republican bullshit. I hate both of them. None of their views make any sense when you can't even debate them. Like, what happened to good debate? There's no good debate anymore. Like, your views
make
no sense to me when you can't even change people's minds, because you just make fun of each other.
Right. Well, the internet's the great equalizer here, because if two dumbasses with a couple $100 can put together this recording set up here and reach people, so can the third-party candidate. Like, Jill Stein could have raised enough money to make a huge internet push and get directly to the people.
Yeah.
And you know, the Green Party maybe would have had a shot this year.
Yeah, fucking... And that's when, like, the Tea Party got really popular way back in the day. The real original Tea Party was not Democrat or Republican, and the Republicans hijacked that. Oh, they were still
conservative, though.
Yeah, then the fucking Republicans hijacked that shit. No, the real Tea Party...
Well, they were still very conservative. Their viewpoints were very conservative.
No, the real Tea Party, the real one...
I know the one you're talking about.
That, you know, they were like, come and just talk to us. And right at the beginning, it says we are not Democratic or Republican. And then Sailor fucking Pale Ass, whatever the fuck her name is, hijacked the shit out of it. And then everyone thought it was conservative. And
Paul Ryan.
Yeah.
That fucking little
The original Tea Party was nothing. It was just people calmly talking that it was not Democrat or Republican's fault. It was just the government's. And then they just hijacked it. And it's like, they always got to hijack shit. And it's just like, I'm ready for just, I don't know. The Purge.
I'm ready for some dick and fart jokes, because half of our audience left already.
Yeah, I know. I don't care. I just get fired up.
You got anything else funny?
No, not really. I think that's about it.
Where are we at on time?
I'm pretty good on time. I think that's a good hearty meal.
We had a good hearty debate.
Yeah, a good hearty debate. It's just hard for me. And that's why, like, I had some people like, "Oh, Casey, I'd like to see your side of the, you know, politics and shit." I don't care anymore.
Well, there you go. That was it.
I don't care.
That was his side of the politics.
I think if you follow politics, like, it's not really your fault. I think you're stupid, but it's not your fault. It's just not your fault because they're playing a really good game right now. A really good game. And it's hard not to when you can't even have a fucking email without them telling you shit about it.
Well, it's important to know what's going on in the world today.
I know, but is it? Is it really?
Yes.
Like, Trump's president right now, I'm not affected by it. My life still fucking sucks. I still got to pay my bills and shit like that.
Give it
like
time.
Like I said, find people that love you and just worry about them. And like a lot of people say, worry about your 5-yard radius.
Well,
if you can't control outside your 5-yard radius, don't fucking worry about it.
Well, there's hopeful words to live by.
Yes.
All right, everybody. Well,
I'll freak out.
There's probably likely to be more political debates between us over the next 4 years because you know what? The fact of the matter is, it's the biggest thing that's going on in the world today.
Yeah. So, I know, and that's the thing. I'm not used to talking about pop culture.
I am, but, you know, that's my thing. So
the only thing I'm used to talking about that has the word pop in it is the sound that my dick makes when it comes out of a vagina.
All like right, everybody.
Thanks again, everyone.
Until next week, we'll see you later. Have a good one. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe button.
Actually, before we go, if anyone cares at all, I want everyone on Facebook and Twitter. I don't care, you know, if you know your grandsons do it. Everyone, I want them to wish Jay a happy vasectomy. Like, if anyone cares, and anyone even like watches this. Everyone just spam Jay with happy or you know, good luck on your vasectomy. Twitter.
Well, we don't even know. I didn't get there yet. They might scare me off.
Just do it. Just do it. You got it. All right. Thanks, everyone.
All right. See you next week.
See ya.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.